My name is Harry Watts, and I was in the Armored Corps, and I ended up in the 5th Division, and I was a dispatch rider with a small group that was called the Divisional Maintenance Area, or short form DMA. Most of the time was spent in Italy from November 1943 till March of 1945. March of 45, we came up to Holland, and we ended up in Holland till D-Day on May the 8th. Being a dispatch rider was a whole different world than I think any other job in the Army. It was a job that had to be content to be on your own because you were alone quite a lot of the time. And in the Armored Corps, I know it was the only job that was strictly volunteer. You volunteered to ride that motorcycle, and at any time you felt that you didn't want to ride the motorcycle anymore, well, you could say, I don't want to do that, and they'd find another job for you in a tank or something like that. Being a dispatch rider to me was an exciting time. I look back and I think of the tremendous responsibility that they give this 19, 20-year-old kid. Just accepted it and went and did it. A lot of my job was delivering messages that were too important to be sent by radio or by telephone. The Germans could tap in and listen to what was being said, so that was what they used the dispatch riders for. We also did convoy work. Sometimes you'd have a truckload of supplies or maybe a few tanks. They would say, take them from point A to point B, and they would give you a map, and away you'd go. We had taken training at Camp Borden, and our trainer there had been a motorcycle stunt rider at the various fairs, and he had given us instructions on how to crash the motorcycle and walk away and protect ourselves. I got to meet some wonderful people and had some wonderful experiences in Italy. The Italians and the Germans had been an alliance, but we arrived there in November, and the Italians had just surrendered and said that they didn't want to participate in Mr. Hitler's war anymore, so we were fighting the Germans and not the Italians. And their gratitude sometimes made for some wonderful friendships that a lot of the guys built up while we were there. My job was such that I was never really engaged in the actual fighting. I was deliver messages pretty close to it, and sometimes I'd be in a position where I'd have to find a hole to get into for maybe an hour or so, but generally I was just riding my motorcycle and fighting the elements.